Great to have Dr. Thomas Zakaria here with me, a classmate of mine from Manipal. We did our BDS together, and then obviously Thomas went on to do his Dr. Thomas Zakaria for you, went on to complete his MDS in oral surgery from AB Shetty. He was a faculty for a very long time, and now he's in Chennai running a very specialized practice on oral surgery. So Thomas, how are we going to do this? I'm going to ask you a series of questions more specific to your practice. And obviously those in oral surgery, either, you know, just completed the MDS or planning for an MDS and plan to get into oral surgery full time, or even practicing for a while, will definitely benefit from the insights that you have to give them. Obviously a lot of dentists today are, you know, reevaluating given the circumstances we are in. So first and foremost, welcome to this, and thank you for taking time out from your schedule. I know you've been busy with a lot of surgeries, but good to have you here.
Thank you very much, Vikram. For the audience, I would like to say Vikram and I go back long, even before Manipal.
Yeah.
We go back to our school days, we were actually in, we studied in Delhi together, and we were in rival schools that used to compete for the quiz competitions in Delhi in the mid-90s. We didn't know each other back then, but as fate would have it, we both landed up in the same institute. And we ended up, being in the quiz team of our college in Manipal. And we took part in a few quizzes, inter-college quizzes. So Vikram and I go back a long way from the mid-90s. And then, of course, Vikram then went on to do his MBA, and I went on to do oral and maxillofacial surgery. So it's good. It's a culmination after almost 25 years that we meet, and he's as a management, a specialist as an MBA, interviewing a maxillofacial surgeon, and it's good. I'm very happy to be on this forum with Vikram, so thank you very much for having me, and I hope this turns out to be a good session.
Absolutely, and for the record, our quiz team was called, we have two names, right? One was called Quiz Gun Murugan, and the other was called Einstein Zende Noi Martin, collapsing the buildings.
German name meaning collapsing new buildings, and of course quiz gun Murugan from the the MTV show on Quick Gun Murugan. So you had we have some great times in Manipal, and so that's like, let's get to some work now on on this program.
Perfect. So the first question So I want to start with, you run a very specialized practice. And so from a surgery point of view, from a surgical point of view, what is the kind of preparation that you have to do? And what are the kind of investigations that you get into preparing for a surgery patient?
I will actually just break up this, the topic on oral and maxillofacial surgery is basically has got two compartments. Basically, you have oral surgery, procedures done under local anesthesia, and then you have maxillofacial surgery, procedures done under major surgery done under general anesthesia. So it's very, we have two very specific facets to our specialty. So a lot of planning is required in both procedures, whether you're doing a procedure under minor or under local anesthesia as a minor oral surgical procedures, or you're doing a major surgery, a major procedure under general anesthesia. Okay, the first and foremost is you have to communicate to the patient. You have to diagnose the issue correctly and communicate what is the problem. You have to communicate very well to the patient. The irony is that, patients underestimate minor oral surgical procedures. They kind of underestimate. They think it's just a simple, plucking a tooth out or removing a tooth, but they don't realize that the complications involved with an impacted third molar removal. Okay, that is the most underestimated, underrated surgical procedure, if you ask me, in my experience. People think, especially the patients, just think it's just like any other tooth extraction, okay, but it is not. Only an oral surgeon will know the difficulties, the challenges, the intricacies involved in removing a impacted mandibular third molar. So even a simplest procedure like that, you have to tell the patient that it is not what you think. Okay, there are a lot of complications associated with it, unexpected complications, okay? And you have to prepare the patient very well for that. You know, so that is the irony. They underestimate a minor oral surgical procedure like an impacted tooth. And sometimes, you know, they kind of overestimate a major surgical procedure, a maxillofacial surgical procedure, which actually need not be, which is not really such a, many times it is not such a major surgical procedure as such. But you have to explain both. It is especially crucial in a minor oral surgical procedure like an impacted tooth removal. See, the thing is, sometimes an impacted tooth is very close to the inferior alveolar nerve, inferior alveolar canal. So removing such a tooth will cause a patient to have some sort of paresthesia of the inferior alveolar nerve and the lingual nerve. Okay, sometimes they will end up with numbness of the lower lip and the tongue. So if you feel that an impacted tooth is very close to the canal, you have to go for a second investigation. And an IOP or OPG will not do. You have to go for a CBCT. And you have to study the CBCT and see how close to the nerve the particular impacted tooth is. And then explain to the patient that post-operatively, he could have some sort of a numbness, a transient numbness, which could last a few weeks to his lower lip. Okay, apart that is the most serious complication from an impacted third molar. You can get a prolonged or even a permanent numbness of your the sensory nerve, the nerve supplying the lower lip or the tongue. You know, that's the inferior alveolar nerve or the lingual nerve. Second immediate complication is you have to tell the patient that 2 days after removal of an impacted tooth, you're going to get swelling. Okay, the swelling will size depending on the how complicated the procedure was, how difficult the tooth was. Some very deep impacted tooth where you have to remove a lot of bone will end up with a larger swelling. You have to tell the patient that there is going to be swelling. It is normal. Every patient who undergoes an impacted tooth with cutting of the bone will get a swelling. Swelling can be minimized by giving various medications, but it is unavoidable. But it can be it can be reduced. It can be managed. So you get swelling. You even get a difficulty opening the mouth completely. You get difficulty chewing hard foods. So you have to explain all these things to a patient, because the problem is a patient is going to underestimate. A patient will not know the difficulties involved with removing an impacted third molar. They think it's just like removal of any tooth. You give injection and you kind of remove the tooth. So especially third molar, you have to prepare the patient for this. Explain to them there's going to be swelling, pain, difficulty opening the mouth, difficulty eating for a week or so. And if the X-ray show, if the radiograph, the investigation show the tooth is going to, is close, very closely related to the nerve, there could be a temporary, a temporary paresthesia or transient damage to the inferior alveolar nerve, which may resolve, but you have to get a written informed consent. Okay, for an impacted third molar, in case you're going to have, if the tooth is very close to the nerve and the nerve gets damaged, okay, of course there are ways to prevent it. If a tooth is very close to the nerve, you don't remove that part of the tooth. It is better to leave that particular part of the tooth there rather than risk a permanent nerve damage. But in case the tooth is close to the nerve and you do remove the tooth and the nerve is disturbed, get a written informed consent in a language that is understandable to the patient. Okay, get it countersigned by the patient and by you, that there could be a temporary to prolonged numbness of the lower lip or the tongue because how the tooth was positioned. So prepare them mentally for this. Many people, the common mistake I see is practitioners, they will kind of they will probably not tell these to the patients in the fear that they may lose the patient. Okay, it is better to lose a patient rather than have a patient with a who's going to nag you for the next few years because you know you did something, you know, you a procedure of yours caused him some sort of morbidity, you know, a serious side effect, and you may end up going to court. You may have there might be a medical legal issue. So it is better to protect yourself, especially in private practice. It's extremely crucial to get a, especially third molars, because the problem is the patients, the main issue is patients underestimate the problem, okay, and only you know how difficult it can be, okay. See, these kind of problems will not happen in major surgery because they know that there are a lot of complications and it is a major surgery, so they know there are a lot of risks associated with it, okay. And you know, they are more accepting or rather more understanding in those cases. But in a minor surgical procedure, it may come as a shock to the patient that he ends up with numbness of the lip and the tongue and you know swelling, and you know he will think that you really messed up the case. That is not, you know, so you have to. Doesn't matter, you may lose the patient, okay, but better to protect yourself. Explain to the patient all possibilities, all eventualities, complications. Get a written informed consent so that you are well protected. It doesn't, you may lose the patient. Patient may think that, you know, oh my God, this is too scary. That's okay. That is better than creating a problem and then getting stuck with it and then not having a plan B. And you could be open to litigation if you have not got a written informed consent to the written informed consent of the possible complications. Okay, you are really exposing yourself and open to litigation that time. You know, you can't really, nobody can help you. So minor oral surgery, I would say, is very, very, you know, it is especially third molars, highly underestimated, and a lot of people I know have got into problems because of this, because they underestimate the problem, patients underestimate the problem, and they do not prepare adequately for this, you know. So I always say, if you're removing an impacted third molar, impacted canine, okay, impacted canine, impacted premolar, any difficult impaction, get a CBCT. Plan your surgical procedure. It costs around 1,500 rupees, but it is better. I would refuse a procedure to a patient who says that, I'm sorry, I can't afford a CBCT. I will not do heroics. This is not a time for bravado or heroics, okay? I'd rather be prepared with a plan A, B, and C, rather than go in blindly for a thing that, you know, because in my experience over the last 15 years, I've got into all kinds of problems. I've learned this the hard way, you know. So, you know, CBCT is, my advice to people who are doing impacted teeth are general dentists or oral surgeons. You're doing impacted third molars, impacted canines, impacted premolars, okay? If you feel that tooth is a challenge to remove surgically, if it's close to vital structures like the maxillary sinus, nasal cavity, inferior alveolar nerve, get a CBCT, study it well. If you feel that there's going to be nerve damage or other issues, explain to the patient. Sit with the patient, show him the slides. You can run the CD section by, you can run a scan section by section to the patient and explain to him the exact location of the tooth and the challenges. A patient will actually appreciate the fact that you're sitting with a patient and explaining how difficult his procedure is. You know, he would be much more forgiving and understanding later rather than taking him blindly into a procedure and then making a mess of it. Patients are usually very understanding if you make them understand how difficult it is, you know, and you know, at least, and get a written informed consent. So that is the thing. Always take time to explain a procedure to the patient. You know, don't think you are, don't leave it to your assistants or your juniors to do it. Do it yourself. So this is about minor oral surgical procedures.